Hey friends, welcome to the channel. In this video, I want to show you how to set up logging for Node.js with Winston. Logging is extremely important to get insights on your application while it's in production. Console.log is very unreliable. It just goes to the standard.out, so if you turn off your application, you lose everything. You can set up Winston so it writes everything into a file, you can easily find the logs in a formatted way, or you can set it up in a more advanced way so it sends the log to an observability provider or monitoring tool. In this video, we will install Winston to a sample application, we will create a basic logger, configure Winston, log messages and set the relevant logging levels, then we will test it all out. I have the Winston documentation as a reference. I'll open up my terminal, I'll navigate into the API, npm install Winston. Let's open up VS Code. Let's create a file called logger.ts inside our utils folder. Let's find the code from the documentation, paste it in, import Winston from Winston. Let's tweak this a bit. So we want the default level to be info, and that means we skip logging debug. We want the format to be a bit more complex. We also want the timestamp. So to do that, we do winston.format.compile. We send in winston.format.timestamp and JSON. We don't need the metadata, and for the transport, we are not gonna have two log files. We're just gonna keep it simple. We're gonna have one log file and we're gonna call it app.log. And we also want to see the logs in the console. So we're not gonna have any special logic for production for now. And we are gonna export this. All right, our logger is ready. So now we just have to use it. Let's open app.ts. Let's import the logger and figure out where we're gonna use it. Here, route not found. Let's log our warning there. Say route not found. And here, when an error occurs, error, oops, an error. And then pass in the error object. All right. So now we just need to run the application. Let's look at the readme. And here we just have to follow some steps. I'll fast that forward. And now the app is up and running. Let's recreate these errors. So first we're just gonna call a get. We'll use counter client for that, do a new request and do a get. And we see it's working, and now let's have an invalid path. So that should yield an error. And let's check our console. Route not found. Awesome. And then we go back and we're gonna do a post. Send in the body. So this should work, but this should not work. And you can see there's an error here. And let's verify our file, our log file. And here we see both the warning and the error. Mission successful. Thank you for this video. I hope you enjoyed it. Please like and subscribe if you'd like to see something more related to logging and maybe sending logs to CloudWatch or something.